Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in your school, or we can say that welcome in our online session. So just now you have completed or you are promoted to the class 8. So in the class 8 for the academic year 21-22, I am going to teach you about the biology. Okay, I am going to deal with the subject, that is what? Biology. And myself, Tejashri Shirsagar. So this year along with you, we are going to discuss about the different topics regarding the biology. So regarding the biology, today we are going to discuss about the very important lesson from the standard 8, and the name of the lesson is Cell Structure and Function. Okay, so it is a very important lesson, like that I said, because as we know that there are the variety of the living things present on the earth. Okay, so like that if I say that what are the living things, so which are the living things present on the earth, then the answer comes in your mind is what? Then there are the animals, there are the plants, and there are the human beings. So all are the living things. And in your previous some classes, or I can say that in the classes 6, you have learned that the living things are made up of cell. Okay, so the living thing is a made up of cell. So what is meant by the cell? What is their exactly structure? What is their function? What they do in our body? Okay, we are going to try, or we are going to find out all the answers of this question in this upcoming discussion of our lesson, that is what? Cell structure and function. So just now I said that in your previous classes, or I can say that in the classes, in the class 6, you have learned about what? Cell. Or I can say that each and every living organism is made up of cell. But what is meant by cell? Who discovered the cell? Who found out this name? Why only the name is given? So let's try to find out the answer of this cell question. So first we will discuss with the first point from the lesson, that is discovery of cell. Okay, so now discovery means what? The cell was already present, but it is just need to tell them everyone, it is need to say to everyone what is mean by the cell. So if we talk about the discovery of the cell, in that discovery of the cell, the one scientist was there, and the name of that scientist was Robert Hooke. Okay, so the Robert Hooke discovered the cell. Okay, in the year 1665. So in the year 1665, Robert Hooke discovered the cell. But how he exactly discovered the cell? What experiment he has done? So let's discuss about that. So in the year 1665, Robert Hooke observed the slice of cork. Now cork means what? As you know, there is a bark for the tree. So the one piece of the bark he has observed under his microscope. But very important thing, students, we have to keep in the mind is that that tendency in which we are discussing about the 1665. So in that 1665, at that time there was not well developed microscope, there was not high magnifying microscope. So Robert Hooke observed the cork, or the slice of the cork, under his microscope, and that microscope is called as what? Hooke's microscope. Okay, so when he observed that cork, or when he observed that slice of the cork, or what is meant by the cork? The bark of the tree, or the piece of the bark of tree. When he observed that cork, then he find out that some partitions are present in that cork. Okay, and each and every partition is different from each other. Okay, there are the some boxes, or there are this like bricks like structures are present in the cork, and then each bricks is separated from each other. Okay, and that is the name, that is the reason he has given this each separate box name as a cell. Okay, name as a cell. So what is mean by the cell? We can say that cell means what? Empty room. Okay, cell means what? Empty room. So when the Robert Hooke observed the cork, or the slice of the cork under his microscope, he found out that there are some empty spaces are there, but that each empty space box is separate from each other, and that is the reason he has given the name for that each empty box as a sale. Okay, so in this way we can say that the robber who coined the sale, or we can say that the robber who discovered the sale in the year 1665. After that, he has discovered about the sale. After this discovery, there was not that much studies done about the sale. After the 150 years, okay, after the 150 years, there was a vast study going on. There was a vast discovery. So many different things, so many different or new things comes out about the sale. Why this much time? Because that time there was not that much magnifying microscope. Okay, but now see about today, we know so much and more information about the sale. We are having the so many important things about the sale. We know the so many important things about the sale. Okay, why is it so? Because in today's or in this today's century, we are having the well magnifying or the high magnifying microscope. In that microscope, we can see the each and every part of the cell, each and every cell organelle that we are going to discuss in our previous these upcoming lectures. Okay, so this is about what discovery of the cell. Okay, and after the 150 years, that people comes to know that what the cell is also the living material in the organisms. The cell is a living thing present in the organisms. Okay, so this is all about what discovery of the cell. Now we move for the next point from the lesson, that is what the cell. Now we have discovered or we know about the discovery of the cell, and here what we have discussed, cell means what? Empty box. So why these boxes, why this empty space is necessary in the body? Yes, it is very, very important in our body, because as you know, might be some constructions are going on in your surrounding. So to give the proper shape for the building, the contractor or that architects are using the bricks. Okay, why they are using the bricks? Because the bricks gives the proper shape to the building. Okay, in this way, same thing is going on in our body. But who is the bricks in our body? Who makes our body? That is what cell. Okay, so what we can say that the cell is the basic structural unit of living organism. Okay, the cell is a basic structure. It gives the structure. It performs the different functions in our body. So that is the reason. What is the cell? Is the basic structural units of living organism. Okay, so we can say that this is the exact definition of the cell. Cell is the basic structural unit of living organism. So if the organism is big, for like that we can say elephant, or if the organism is very tiny, like a ant, like that very big animals also, very small animals also, each and every organism is made up of what? Cell. Each and every organism is made up of cell. Without cell, no, it is not possible to build up the human body or to build up the living things. Okay, so in this way we can say the cell is the basic structural unit of all living organism. So as we know, we are eating the eggs. Are you eating the egg? Yes, obviously you are eating the eggs. Okay, so in that eggs, or that eggs, you can see that that is nothing but what? A single cell that we can easily see with our naked eye. Okay, but actually if we want to observe the different cells which are present in our body, then we cannot see them very easily. To observe that cell, we have to use the different magnifying microscope. With the help of that, we can observe the cell. But hen egg is easily we can see, and that is also what? Single cell. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the discovery of the cell, and also we have discussed about the cell. In that we have discussed the definition of the cell. So today's your homework is that you have to read this same point from the textbook. Okay, so this is all about today. Here we will stop. This is the time to tell you goodbye. We'll meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.